Number five, now we get to work with some numbers. Last sentence first, it says rows X3 unfavorable variable overhead efficiency variance was. Let's read that again. There, unfavorable variable overhead efficiency variance. All right, unfavorable variable overhead efficiency variance, that's this. Efficiency, and they're saying it's unfavorable, negative. That means this has got to be bigger than this. Now remember, this variance is all what? It's all variable anyway, right? There's no fixed. Fixed is the same, it's only variable. So they're saying variable. They could have just said efficiency variance, you should know it's variable. Volume variance, you know is fixed. This one is both, so you'd have to figure it out. Is it the fixed or the variable part? But here, this is all variable. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna clean it up, and we're gonna try to throw some numbers in. This is kind of our test to see if it makes sense. If it does, awesome. If it doesn't, we'll go back and we'll do it a couple of more times. And then also just kind of hope that this doesn't show up in too much detail, right? We'll just kind of pray. All right, here we go. It says the following information pertains to row codes X3 manufacturing operations. We have standard direct manufacturing labor hours per unit, 2. Actual direct manufacturing labor hours, 10,005, so that's actual hours. Number of units produced, 5,000, that's actual. Standard variable overhead per standard direct manufacturing labor hour. So standard variable overhead per what? Per direct labor hour. So what is our base? Our base is labor hours, and that's $3 an hour. Actual variable overhead is 28,000 bucks. So that's why, as I said earlier, what I like to do is I always like to do what? I always like to start with my actual. Why? Because actual is given. So the actual variable overhead. So we're looking only at variable in this case. So here's fixed, we don't know, here's variable. Our variable overhead is 28,000 bucks. Now when you look at variable, the overhead, 28,000, that's based on what? That's based on actual direct labor hours of 10,500. So therefore, if I wanted to break it out, 28,000, which is 28,000 divided by what? Let's see, 28,000 divided by, what do we say? 10,500 equals $2.66. So 266. So to calculate the 28,000, it's really what? It's really 10,500 actual, or let's do it the other way since we did the cost. Let's $2.66 times actual, which is 10,500. So it's 10,500 hours at 266 per hour. How did I get it? I just took 28,000. I didn't have to do this, but I'm gonna show you why because it's easier to compare a little bit later. Okay, now as I move across, let's see what other numbers they gave us. They gave us that our standard overhead was $3. So remember, it's gonna be actual at actual. This is my flexible budget. It's gonna be standard allowed for actual. It's gonna be standard allowed for what? Standard allowed for actual. And then over here, boom, same thing. So these numbers are gonna be the same. Why? Because the difference is fixed, which they didn't ask us. But they're asking us for this difference, which you know is gonna be different because this variance, efficiency, is all variable. This variance, volume, is all fixed. So what I need to figure out is standard allowed for actual. Let's see. How much is standard direct manufacturing labor hours per unit? 2. How much is actual production? 5,000. Therefore, this is gonna be 5,000 at 2, which is 10,000. This is also going to be 10,000. So let's go through it again. We've got actual 28,000, which I showed you was 10,5 at 266. They gave me the 10,5. I just divided that to get 266, just so you could compare. So when we set up, we said, hey, we budgeted $3, and this is $3 variable overhead per direct manufacturing labor hour. So our base was $3 an hour. And we budgeted 10,000. We go, it should be 30,000. But here we've got actual of 28,000, which means it actually cost 266, that's good, but it took 10,500 hours, okay? Let's do that. Compare. This is flexible budgeted actual, so take actual here, but this is standard allowed for actual. Boom. And that gives us what? 31,500. This is going to be standard allowed based on what got applied. Standard allowed. So over here, it's going to be 30,000, and this is also going to be 30,000. So obviously, this is our volume variance, which is zero because it's not variable, it's all fixed. This is going to be our efficiency variance, which is all variable. So it's going to be 1,500 unfavorable because this is bigger than this. This, they didn't ask for, is going to be 28, 29, 30, 31, 3,500. And in looking at this 3,500, since this is bigger than this, this is favorable. All right, so this is the variable, this would be our spending variance. What happened? We actually spent 28,000. We basically, based on our budget, based on actual, should have spent 31,500. Oh, good job. Based on flexible budget at actual, 31,500, but we only did what? We basically applied, boom, boom, 30,000. So we were less efficient. Why? Because it should have taken us 10,000 hours. Remember, we budgeted 10,000 hours. We sat down and we said 2 hours, 5,000. 2 hours was standard, 5,000 was actual production. So that's standard allowed for actual. It took 10,000. It should have taken us 10. It took us 10,500. That's $500 at 3 is the $1,500. And then as you move over, this again is the volume variance, which there's no variable volume difference. It would have been all fixed, but there wasn't any. They didn't ask us for the fixed. So one more time, because I know if you're like me, when you put numbers to it, that's when it starts to make sense. Starting over here, actual. What's our actual? 28,000. How did you get it? They just got you a bill. They gave you a bill and they said, hey, we spent 10,500 hours and it cost us 266. For what? For electricity. This is variable overhead. Variable overhead, electricity, rent, whatever the, not rent, rent's fixed, but electricity, air conditioning, heat. Something that the more hours, the more cost. It's not fixed, it changes. So 266. We budgeted 3. 266, that's good. That's why it's going to be favorable. And the same hours because we use actual actual. This is actual. This is flexible budget. Close to actual, use flexible budget at actual. So that's where this came from, 3,500 favorable, but they didn't ask for the spending variance. Then moving on, we actually used 10,500 hours and $3 was our budget. We should have used 3 at 10,000, which is 2 standard allowed for actual production. Boom. Therefore, it's off by 1,500. That is 1,500 unfavorable. Okay, so again, I realize it's a tricky area. I realize it's an area that most of us never understood before my lecture, but after watching it a few times, hopefully it makes a little bit more sense. All right, in a minute, we'll move on to some more fun stuff.